As folks know, we saw historic turnout in Georgia. Over 3.9 million Georgians have voted. That is over 1.3 million more votes than 2014. As Stacey shared last night, and as I shared, we are committed and remain committed to ensure that every vote is counted. We saw significant irregularities, long wait times in Fulton County, despite a warehouse with 700 machines that stood at the ready to be deployed but never were. We feel we owe a fight to voters, to those million new voters, to all Georgia voters, to make sure every vote is counted. So right now, in terms of the numbers, Secretary Kemp is just 15,539 votes above the runoff threshold. As you know, in Georgia, to get to an outright win, you must get to 50% plus one. When you look at the margin overall, we're about 15,000 votes from that runoff threshold as of 9:52 a.m. this morning. So when you look at those votes and you look at those numbers and we're tracking what still is outstanding, we're still seeing outstanding mail ballots trickling in several counties, including the large county of Gwinnett and the smaller county of Clark. They're mainly mail ballots that are still trickling in. In fact, of the 15,000 that we're looking for to meet the runoff threshold, we think there are about that many mail ballots alone that still remain to be processed. And when you consider that on top of the incredible amount of irregularities and issues we saw across early voting, absentee balloting, and election day voting, from long lines, provisional ballots, paper ballots, we're looking at potential thousands of additional votes and voters that need their votes counted. Many of you have heard me say before that we've expected problems. We have attempted to be prepared in every way, shape, or form in this campaign. We've been running a large voter protection and legal operation, and that operation is now activating to ensure that we fight for every vote, like we did yesterday, to delay the closure of county polling locations in Gwinnett. So our legal team, our voter protection team, and our field team are activating this morning to make sure we understand what's happening on the ground in all 159 counties. And we will be aggressive, deliberate, and thoughtful to make sure that voters feel as though the process is as fair and transparent as possible and that their votes are counted. So overall, we feel that the onus is on our campaign to fight for fairness, for a fair election, and we're up against an unfair system where our own opponent is overseeing his election.